come upon somebody seizing, we're going to use the TRUST acronym to work through seizure first aid. The first thing you're going to want to do is to turn them onto their side into what is a first aid position and a safety position where they are going to be able to move without restraint, but also to be best protected. We like for patients having seizures to be on their side because if they were to drool or vomit, it's going to be able to come out, so you don't have to worry that it's going to be aspirated back into the lungs so they won't get infected afterwards. The next thing you're going to do is remove any glasses that they may be wearing, whether they're sunglasses or regular glasses. You're also going to loosen a tie, buttons, zipper, anything that may be constricting the neck. You're going to want to open that up so that they'll have movement and be able to breathe when they can. The next thing you're going to use is something to put underneath their head. We will typically say if you're at home, you're going to use a pillow or a blanket, but if you're out somewhere else, you can use jackets, backpacks, anything you can find. If there isn't anything available, use your hands or you can place their head on top of your lap and use your legs to protect them. The next thing to do is to stay calm. You are going to stay calm not just for yourself, but also for the patient. We tell them, you're okay, everything's fine, I'm right here with you, and everything will be all right. The last thing you want to do is to time the seizure, whether it be on a watch or a phone, that way we know exactly how long the seizure has lasted when EMS comes. This is important because at the 5-minute mark, you may be using rescue medications. We also recommend that any time the patient turns blue in the mouth that you immediately call 911, but this will be important information not only for your doctor, but also for EMS. When people are coming out of a seizure, they're often going to be confused. If you know the patient, you want to use their name. So you say, hi, Moriah, it's Kate. I'm right here with you and you're okay. You just had a seizure. They may not know who you are, even though you may be familiar to them, and they're often going to be confused and maybe a bit combative. So if that happens, just again, stay calm best you can. You don't want to restrain anyone, neither during a seizure nor after a seizure, but you do want to make sure that they stay safe because if they are confused, they are prone to hurting themselves. If you're not sure if they're completely back to their baseline, you always want to ask open-ended questions, not yes-no questions. So ask things like, what's your birthday? How old are you? What's your full name? Not, are you okay? Because someone may be able to say yes when they're still in that postictal or after seizure phase and confused. So the three things that you don't want to do during seizure first aid is going to be, do not put anything in their mouth. You will hear out in the world that people say that you could swallow your tongue during a seizure, but that's not true. And you're actually at more risk for hurting either yourself or the patient if you put something in their mouth, because some people have their jaws locked closed. And then that way, if there was something in there, they could break their teeth, which obviously would be damaging to them or potentially hurt you if you used your hands or fingers. The other thing is, don't restrain them. So you won't be stronger than somebody having a seizure. You will not be able to hold them down in any way, and you're actually, again, at risk for hurting yourself and them. After someone has had a seizure, don't give them any food or drink. They may be thirsty, but remember, they're also confused and may not have the coordination that they'll normally have. So we don't necessarily want to give them anything until we know that they are completely back to their baseline. Also, water safety is incredibly important for people with epilepsy. I always recommend for my patients that they never swim alone. They have to have somebody in the water with them at all times. If you are to be in the water with someone and it's only the two of you, the first thing you want to do is to pull them up out of the water. Depending on the situation, for patients having large tonic-clonic seizures, it may be easier for you to hold them up in the water with their head above the water level than to actually pull them out of the water. So depending on the situation, you may not actually want to pull them out. The most important reason for people with seizures of any kind, whether they're absence, focal, or tonic-clonic, to have somebody in the water with them is the risk of drowning. It doesn't take long for someone to drown, and it doesn't take very much water. This is the reason that patients with epilepsy are at risk even in their own bathrooms. Someone who has a seizure in a shower can actually fall, obstruct the drain, and drown in only about 1.5 to 2 inches of water if their face is in the exact right position. Because of that, it is so important that they are never around water on their own, and this is what we recommend for all children. Never leave them alone, right, in a bathtub. This is gonna be the same for our kids with epilepsy. If you have older children or adults with epilepsy who want to shower on their own, the recommendation is never to lock the shower door, so that if they were to fall and somebody heard it, they would be able to come and get you.